headband on. All right. Oh, Leon, you did? Okay, cool. Thanks for letting me know so I can look for it. All right, so here we go. Let's go over a few things coming in my correspondence with you. Oh, you're starting now, YT? Stars. No, I'm a physical therapist. All right. Star, thank you for the 31 months. I appreciate it. Thank you. Alright, so this is just some correspondence with myself, between myself and YouTube. So I showed them some of the stuff that I've showed y'all in the past, and we'll show some more information on here too. So this is something they sent back. Hey, Mama Anita. So this is something they sent back to me. Said, thank you for reaching out to us. I understand that you're concerned about a user who's impersonating your channel and is harassing you and her other creators live stream. I know how concerning this is to you, and we truly appreciate you bringing this to our attention. To start, we take impersonation on YouTube very seriously, and I provide an option below to help you solve it, which is false, but we'll go over that pretty soon. Impersonation can happen on YouTube in two ways. To fix this issue, first determine what sort of impersonation is happening, then follow the link to get help from our legal team. Is it impersonation of you or your channel? Like someone has copied your channel's profile, background, or text and is running comments to make it look like your channel posted them, which for those that have been living under a rock, they'll know that's what's been going on. How to fix or report the user's channel, which we've done that multiple times. And then someone's created a channel or using your real name and stuff like that. Thankfully, I haven't put that on there, so I haven't done that. So anyway, say submit that information, blah, 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 blah. That was from Neth. Anyway, what happened here? So let me go ahead and let me see what I respond. So that was August 4th, I think. Yeah, August 4th. This is okay. This is me saying something on August 4th back of 2021. So I said, Neth, thanks for reaching out to me. So before, previously, just a heads up. So there was able to, I was doing a live chat regarding this with someone from YouTube support. And, pretty much, I was going back and forth with them for a few minutes, and then they up and just didn't answer me. Up and didn't answer me whatsoever. So, I don't know what happened, if they lost something, lost connection, but they just completely lost. So, that's what I'm referring to when I'm talking to Marie in this email. So, I said, Neth, thanks for reaching out to me. The ways to try to resolve this in your previous email have already been done. I've reported all of the channels in question this troll has used that I am aware of. Regarding the form requiring a photo ID, that does not apply here because the troll is impersonating my brand channel, Pudge007, but my actual name, address, and the like weren't used. However, since my address is Pudge007 in the content creation world and people recognize me with the avatar I use, this person is impersonating me all the same. I previously tried to get help regarding this issue with your colleague, Marie, but I only received prompts to wait for 5 minutes multiple times and pretty much only the same things you just sent to me. Nothing was done about the severity and specific nature of my issue. At one instance, I did not hear anything from Marie in over 20 minutes with no answer as to what was going on or how they were dealing with this situation. So I eventually had to leave the conversation to try and hope to get help elsewhere. I think for you to understand the gravity of what's going on, I will give you more detail here. So here's pretty much, you know, a big detail of generally of what's been going on. And then some examples. My channel is currently under attack from a troll. Continues to impersonate and harass me during my live streams or on other live streams. While I am also simultaneously live streaming. And sometimes even when I'm not, which has happened a lot here in the past few days, actually. So again, this is from August, but this is stuff that's been going on right now, too. They also have prepared by creating multiple accounts so that when they get banned from a live chat, they just come right back with another account and continue the incessant trolling by flooding the live chat with spam, including vulgar language. Here lately, they will flood the live chat of another content creator, usually one that has many more subscribers than me, usually in the hundreds, thousands, or millions, which apparently today, while I was at work, they did this to, apparently they have like 4+ million subscribers. Ben Shapiro's live chat. And they pretty much did it throughout the whole chat, according to Fox. And I've got some things I'm going to show you that screenshots for proof on that as well. But yeah, so it's usually someone that's larger. Maybe not always, but a lot of times they are. So like I said, usually the one that has more subscribers than me, using the hundreds of thousands or millions. While we were both live streaming and personing me and harassing them. And of course, sometimes even when I'm not. A common username they use is Pudge007 is live now, come watch. Or something to that effect, causing the content creator and the community to initially think I'm self-promoting my channel. A huge taboo in the live streaming community. When in fact, it's the troll trying to make me look bad. This causes some of the viewers of the other content creator to think negatively towards me. Come to my live stream, or sometimes to my other videos if I'm not live streaming. And harass me because they believe it's me promoting myself, even when I can demonstrate during my own live stream that I could not be doing such a thing. For example, showing both of my hands on screen during my live stream and the harassment continues to go on in the other content creator's live chat. One of the most recent times this has happened, again, this was in August of this past year. One of the most recent times this happened was during this live stream when I was playing Unmetal. And I give a link to my live stream there. During this live stream, this troll began to harass Muselk, or apparently that's someone that has like millions of subs. And there's the link to their channel. During their own live stream began the typical harassment described above. Again, they targeted a channel that had way more subscribers than me. They have 9.44 million. I'm telling them how many they have then. They have now. The troll has also found a way to glitch the member function on YouTube where they can somehow show they become a member of the channel without actually paying any money. They have done this, and my channel continue to do so myself. This behavior has also happened to a close content creator of mine, Papa Agron, which happened to him. There's his link, where this troll will do the exact same things to him as the troll does to me, impersonates him and harasses other content creators live streaming at the same time as him. Even though these aren't the only two instances, another more recent time this has happened to me was when I was live streaming Luigi's Mansion during this live stream, and I showed the live stream there, there's the link, and they're harassing typical gamers live stream. Apparently, and I think they have a lot more subs than me as well. I'm unsure of the exact date, but this same type of thing happened to Oxhorn, who has millions of subs, previously while we were both live streaming. The most recent occurrence happened when I was live streaming Metal Gear Solid 2. Again, this, when I say recent, that was in regard to this email. This troll began to harass these content creators in this order with the link to the live streams that, where they were harassed next to their names. Troy Dan, Valkyrie, Ella Ivy, Codiations. Unsure of the timestamp, this happened at 10:29 p.m. specifically during Ella Ivy's live stream, and a picture is attached with that screenshot. So I even give proof there. During Codiation's live stream, this happened specifically at the 1 hour 37-minute mark. There are also additional screenshots of this occurring during that live stream. I can't think of any specific examples right now, but this troll will sometimes do the same things to other channels, even when I'm not live streaming, which they did that today while I was at work to Ben Shapiro's live stream. That's just freaking stupid and insane that they would do something like that. And even go to channels that they have nothing to do with gaming. Like I just said there, Shapiro's more of like, you know, political commentator. This troll seems to spend a lot of time and energy impersonating, harassing, bullying me and other content creators on this platform while specifically aiming their hatred towards me to try and get me to stop creating, or maybe in hopes that some will believe the troll and thinking I'm the one actually engaging in those outrageous and atrocious behaviors and try to get my channel removed. I hope that you can use all the tools at your disposal to pinpoint the person doing this in order to keep them from keep this from happening to me or anyone else on your platform again. Because the way things are handled right now almost makes it impossible to stop this trollish behavior. I have already gone through the usual channels of reporting all those channels that I'm aware of this troll has used to harass me and others. Unfortunately, those accounts are still around, and it seems this troll continues to just make more anyway when any channel gets removed. Also, as you already know, I've already tried doing chat with YouTube support already, and that did not help to resolve the issue. Here's a list of the channels this troll uses that I'm aware of that they have used to harass and impersonate me. So, I'm actually just going to click. So, these are some of the channel links that I gave to them so they can look at. I'm just going to click on one of them. Let's see what pops up. Look at that. That's one of them they use a lot where it has dicks. So there's one that they use. Still up, by the way. It's still up. They still haven't taken it down. S word. One they'll use to spam things out of. Let's see if this one's still up. Look. Hey, look. They impersonated Make It. See, I didn't even know who Make It Look Easy was when I made this email. They're impersonating Make It Look Easy right now. Made that July 10th. I didn't know him then. And that, so they still use that account and put his name on there. They're impersonating someone else right now with that particular link. And YouTube still has it up. What else have we got? I don't know who that is, but that's probably impersonating somebody. Let's see. Throbby, that's another one that would use over and over in live chats. Let's see. And there's another one, the Dix one. Look. Pudge 007 they're of my bot right there. See, impersonating me and my bot that I use. Let's see, what else? That's another terrible thing there. Hey, Dammy. Yes, Gaming Cube, exactly. So this is something that I've tried to. Hey, Dammy, how are you doing? Hold on just a second. How are you doing? Anyone else coming from that channel? See, there's another one. Dicks. Blah, 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 blah. So, I mean, there's a lot of other ones there. Hey, Lucina. And there's another one that I've seen a lot of that they've used to spam in chats. Mine and others. Biden 2024, Biden saved America, blah, 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 blah. So, anyway, let's welcome these raiders. I'm taking care of some stuff, raiders, but welcome in.
I'm under enemy fire. Secure the perimeter.
Lucas, Miss Me Too Chan, I'm probably screwing the name up. Androsi's the Hard, Gaming Cube Head, Rain Wainwright, what's up? Presnick, some chess. Okay, nice. Thank you, Nicholas. We're gonna get to some of the gameplay in a minute, but I'm just taking care of some stuff. Some Hager Rick Wild Speaker. So if you just came in with the raid, just so you know, we will be doing some Resident Evil 3 remake. We're doing a Resident Evil marathon right now, but just a lot of crap has happened. Oh yeah, Dammy, let me check. Let me do it real quick. Dammy plays. There we go. Hey, Dark Matter, how are you doing? Thanks so much for raiding. There's Dammy plays right there. Be sure to check out their channel. Hey, James. Hello, everybody. I haven't said hi to everybody yet, and I'm sorry. I usually do. I'm taking care of some stuff just to show how YouTube has done a lack of doing their job. Pretty much just proving that they're just letting people get away with quote-unquote murder. But anyway, thank you so much for the raid. Let's see, another one here. Let's see, piss. Yeah. Anyway, let's see, what's another one here? See, there's another one of those Biden Saved America ones. That they'll go on and it's just insane. So anyway, that's not all of them per se, but that's a lot of them. See, they removed one apparently, but those are all. That's not even all of them. That's a lot of. There's like 20 something. There's like 20 something accounts that they have there. That's not even all of them that they would use. A lot of them are still up right now. Got to. posted some stuff. Oh, let me do this. Brendan, I'm sure they had that one too. Hey, what's up, Phoenix? How you doing, buddy? All right, so here's one screenshot that they did in someone's stream. Now we're ourselves. Pudge007 is live now. Come watch. Pudge007 is live. Blah, blah, blah. That's one of them. Here's another one in someone else's channel. Still impersonating me saying Pudge007 is live now. And in another one where they said, had semen. And it says Pudge007 is live. That's just a couple. Those are minor examples. Let me show you the ones that happened today in Ben Shapiro's channel. Let me show you that one. That Fox took for me. Demi, I probably don't deserve a lot of those because a lot of those are probably from people that don't need to be subs. It's probably from that person anyway, but anyway. All right. What was I doing? I don't know, Phoenix. What happened? Let me find it. Thought I had it. All right, here we go. That was a lot of me anyway. So this was today. So this is Shapiro's live stream. And there's that Biden 2024, Biden saved America. Watch Pudge007 on YouTube. Again, I wasn't live streaming at the time. I was at work when all this crap was going down. So that's one of them. Apparently, this is the whole stream long, too. And then, there, look, if you see there, they've taken my profile pictures. It's Pudge007 streaming live now, even though it wasn't. Come watch, blah, blah, blah. Pudge007 on YouTube. And then, of course, then go to your live, Pudge. And then people are saying, it's probably the same person, but it's saying that I'm doing stuff that's wrong to do with kids. That's just awful that they would even insinuate something like that. And then this one's saying that I run bad stuff on Discord. You can kind of read that maybe, but still. Thank you, Dammy Plays. Yeah, I know, Dammy. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you raided during this time. But something that I have to take care of. But thank you so much for being here. So that was today. I'm sorry, Phoenix, about that happening to you. Yes, Mama Nita, on Ben Shapiro's live chat. Yes. Anyway, I gotta scroll down. I don't want to see any names here. Right, so I sent all that stuff to him. It said that I ran a pedophile thing on Discord, which is obviously not true. They were just spouting that out too. Okay, so they said, thank you for your immediate response. I also appreciate you sharing detailed information of the issue as well as providing us with these screenshots. I know how important it is for you to have this matter resolved, that this could harm your image on our platform. I wanted to thank you for alerting us to this issue, and no worries, I'll be more than happy to assist you with this. I've escalated the issue to the appropriate team, and they're currently investigating. It might take some time before I can respond, but I'll follow up as soon as I have more information. As for your query regarding the troll being able to become a member without paying any money, I ask you to send us feedback, which I did. They didn't do anything about this, by the way, but I gave them feedback. Your feedback goes directly to our internal team. We use it to troubleshoot issues, make product improvements, and fix problems such as this. Rest assured, we may be able to reply to every report. We're reviewing and working to fix issues as fast as we can. Thanks for your patience and understanding. Let me know if you have any other questions. In the meantime, I'll be more than happy to help. Anyway, I said, Neth, I really appreciate your response and you providing the info to the appropriate team so they can investigate this matter. It has been beyond traumatic and frustrating, and it is much appreciated your listening and dealing with the specific needs of this situation. Yeah, you're good, Phoenix. I love you, buddy. Have a good day, dude. Sorry, I'm kind of taking care of stuff, but I'll be thinking and praying for you, man. I know dealing with something like this will take some time, so I appreciate you letting me know that beforehand, that it would actually take some time to resolve and figure out. Even so, I will definitely be eager to hear your response for what information you're able to obtain and provide back to me. I'll also be sure to provide more detailed information in the link you provided regarding the membership glitch. I'm sure this troll won't be finished harassing me, so I'll provide you even more detailed information that continues to occur, which I'm sure it will, and it did. So you can forward it to the appropriate team that deals with these types of situations. Dyson, I'm a doctor of physical therapy. I'm a physical therapist. Thanks again. I eagerly await your response of what comes of this crazy and frustrating situation. And they said again, hi there. Thank you for immediate response. I totally understand how frustrating this can be, and we truly appreciate you letting us know about this matter. I know this is taking time, but just bear with me. Rest assured, our internal team is already investigating the issue, and as soon as I hear from them, I'll let you know right away. I also appreciate your cooperation and meeting feedback regarding the issue with membership. Our team will also review your feedback and fix problems as soon as possible. Once again, thank you for your continued patience and cooperation. Should you have any other issues or concerns, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. All right, so again, so something else happened. So I said, Neth, just wanted to give you an update on my end about what this troll has continued to do to me, my community, and other content creators. They are essentially doing the same thing, using multiple accounts, impersonating me, harassing other content creators while myself and the other content creators live streaming and acting as if I'm promoting my channel live stream during theirs, via spamming messages to make me look bad to other content creators and their communities. This hasn't happened in the past week or so because I was on vacation. However, I began live streaming today during this live stream, show this, and the troll was at it again. The troll did it to these content creators with the respective live streams they were also doing while I was live streaming. So I'm giving the person and also the live stream. Dyson, thank you. I am. Appreciate it. So United Gamer was one. Again, a lot bigger channel than mine. Swavy, Blitzwinger, Rosabel Vlogs, and B-Midnight9. It seems this troll is continuing to use many of the same channels that I and many others from the community have already reported, and they are still being allowed to use those same channels. Some of the names of these channels include This Stream is Trash, come watch Pudge007. The Semen one multiple times. Again, this is a quote. This is not my quote. This is a quote of something they used, and I quote, "Women are good for blowjobs, nothing else." That's that quote. That's one of the ones that they were using to harass other people with. And Pudge007 is live now. Come watch. It's getting to the point that every time that I live stream, I cannot do so in peace. And even when I'm not live streaming now. Because I'm always having to worry about not if the troll will strike, but when they will. It seems they strike almost every live stream now, and it makes it to where live streaming on your platform is toxic and unenjoyable. I am also attaching many screenshots that my moderators have gathered that support these claims. This troll also said a few things in my live stream today with screenshot proof. Looking forward to your response about how this investigation is going. So, here's one of the screenshots. Let's see, look. I can't see what they said, but this is one that they were spamming one of them with. The stream is trash. Couldn't watch. Say they're doing that in United Gamers channel. That's United Gamers right there. This one's B-Midnight9. This is Pudge007 is live now. The stream is trash. Let's see. This was one in mine. So, yeah. So, they did this in mine. Thank you for using our promotion package. Your session expires. Please top up to continue using our service. Again, they are doing that in my own channel there. So, let's see. This is one with Swavy. Swavy's, and they were using the Semen one over and over and over and over. Here's another one. They had to put it in members only mode. So this was, I can't remember whose this is, but anyway. Anyway, so that was another one. And then here's their response. Hi there. I hope you're doing well. I'm Alexis, and I'll be taking over this case on behalf of my colleague, Neth. I know how important it is for you to protect your channel from being impersonated by other channels, and that was harassing. No worries. Let me help you out. I forwarded the information you've shared over to our internal team. As of this time, we're still waiting for them to complete the investigation. Sorry, Mario. I know this is boring. I'll be reaching out to you once we have more details about this case. We do appreciate your cooperation. Blah, 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 blah. And I said, thank you, Lexus. I'm doing okay, but it's been deflating and frustrating to say the least. I'm still having to deal with this troll day after day. Thanks for forwarding that information to your team. I'll continue to provide new details as they arise in hopes they will help in the investigation. Looking forward to what you're able to figure out. And then they said, hi there, thanks for contacting us. I know how hard it is for you dealing with these trolls that you've experienced on our platform. We just want you to let you know that here on YouTube, we do not treat you as customers, but you are our partner. We are here to help you out. Let us work together to resolve this. Our internal team updated us that they're still reviewing your case. They thanked you for giving us more information to speed up the review process. As promised, I'll keep you updated once our team provides us more details on this case. For now, I know that it's already hard for you to wait, but let us wait together for our team to provide more details on how we can take action on this case. So here's the kicker right here. Hi there. I hope all is well. This is Arian stepping in for Lexus. Apologies for the delayed response. Due to a high volume of email, we received our response maybe later than usual. I just received an update from our internal team. We are unable to identify a community guidelines violation in the content you reported. All the stuff I just showed you earlier, they did not see one community guideline violation for impersonation, for harassment, none of those. For more information regarding our community guidelines, please visit this link. Travis, love you, buddy. So here's what I said. Arian, I am deeply saddened by this cookie-cutter response I have received from you regarding this query. It is painstakingly obvious you and your internal team do not understand or do not seem to want to understand the situation I have provided to you in utmost detail. Also, even if you did not understand the full situation, the fact that you and your internal team were unable to identify any violations of the community guidelines is laughable at best. First, let me address the problem with your suggestion to reach out to the content creator in question. If you and your internal team were even remotely aware of my situation, you would understand the troll is not a content creator. This troll has created numerous accounts, at least 25 plus, but probably more, to impersonate me and to harass me and other content creators who actually produce content. This troll did not produce one video in any of the accounts that I provided for you that this one troll used to harass me. Also, on none of those accounts was there any contact information provided. This should be no surprise because trolls live off anonymity. They do not want to be contacted or to be reached. That's their whole scheme. Impersonate, harass, and do so without people knowing who they are. Hold on just a second. Second, just a brief search of the community guidelines on YouTube shows this troll definitely violated at least three of the guidelines. I will state which three and provide examples of all these. Number one. Impersonation policy. The troll has used multiple accounts to use my brand name, Pudge007, to have other people believe it was me or fans of my channel were self-promoting my content live streams on other content creators' live streams, even on one of them. They used my specific profile picture so people would believe it was me. As per examples provided on the impersonation policy on the community guidelines. Using someone else's real name, username, image, brand, logo, or other personal information to trick people into believing you are that person. Setting up a channel using the name and image of a person and then pretending that person is posting content to that channel. Or C, setting up a channel using the name and image of a person and then posting comments in other channels as if they were posted by that person, which, as you've seen, they've done that. So according to the community guidelines, it is impossible for the troll not to have violated the impersonation policy. Spam, I'll say number two, spam, deceptive practices, and scam policies. This troll incessantly goes to other content creators who are live streaming and spamming the same comments over and over that impersonates me or a fan of my channel, telling the targeted content creator that their content sucks and that they should watch my content live streams instead. I have already provided multiple and various screenshots of this, as per examples provided on the Spam Deceptive Practices and Scams Policy section on the community guidelines. Let's see. Okay, sorry. Repetitive comments, leaving large amounts of identical untargeted repetitive comments. Hey, check out my channel video here, when the channel video has nothing to do with the video it was posted, except, of course, the troll is doing this impersonating me or a fan of mine. Again, according to the community guidelines, it is impossible for the troll not to have violated the spam deceptive practices and scam policies. Number three, harassment and cyberbullying policies. Like I've said before, this troll has gone out of their way to harass other content creators and myself. They typically do this with usernames that target me, other content creators, or even other marginalized communities. For example, they will use a username often called, "This stream is trash, come watch Pudge007, which insults me by impersonating me and insults the content creator they are targeting in their live stream and calling them trash. They have also used the name, "This stream is for," again, I quote, so it's the RETARDS. Come watch Pudge 007. I just don't want to say it. Many times. Which generally speaks very disrespectfully of people with mental impairments. As well as calling out the targeted content creator by name. Like, they did one time, they did Muselk is a loser. Come watch Pudge 007. So they're calling and harassing a specific person. They also use usernames that targets women in general using the cyber name "Women are good for blowjobs, nothing else." As for examples provided on the harassment and cyberbullying policy section on the community guidelines, accounts dedicated entirely to focusing on maliciously insulting an identifiable individual. Target an individual based on their membership in a protected group, such as saying, "Look at this filthy slur. I wish they'd get hit by a truck." This is YouTube's words. Using extreme insult to dehumanize an individual based on their intrinsic attributes. For example, "Look at this dog of a woman. She's not even a human being. She must be some sort of mutant or animal." Rating or directing malicious abuse to identifiable individuals through in-game voice chat or messages during a stream. Once again, according to the community guidelines, it is impossible for the troll not to have violated the harassment and cyberbullying policies. You said in your email that you love to ensure that you provide the best possible security and assistance. I noticed that the URLs I submitted to your team that the troll used are still in use and have not been removed. And they still aren't, except for maybe one. You and your team have the ability to deal with this situation if you so desire. If you really want to ensure the best possible security and assistance while showing you want to actually help assist this content creator on your platform, I would like to know how you and your team will be dealing with this troll to provide the non-toxic environment all content creators deserve on your platform, no matter how many views or subscribers they have. I eagerly anticipate your response to this query. Hi there. I hope all is well. My name is Zeke, and I'll be taking over this case. This is their response. We do appreciate you taking your time and effort in contacting us to report these channels. We're here to help. We do understand how important this means to you, Bull. When it comes to these kinds of scenarios, although we want to help the other channels as well, we value the privacy of our partners and can only access the channel and account of one who is contacting us. Bullshit! We suggest that the other partners who are being harassed should contact us as well so that the reports will be documented and our internal team will know the big impact these fake channels have made. Also, we know that you've been harassed via comments as well, so I'd like to let you know that you also have the power to block those existing comments that were left by the channel and block the commenter as a whole so they won't be able to continue commenting on your future videos and live streams. Just that right there just shows you they have no clue of what the hell they're talking about or what's going on. Hey, Kevin. Hey, everybody. Hey, Shadow Wolf. Hey, Hot Pocket. Hey, Leon. Hey, Baby Squatch. Anyway, we know this is not a permanent solution since, as you mentioned, they can always create other fake accounts. However, we have a countermeasure in place wherein if a channel has been terminated for any violation of our community guidelines, the channel owner won't be able to create or manage other channels as well. You can read more about this policy here, blah, 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 blah. We suggest that you and your fellow creators who are impacted by these channels work together to bring these channels down for good. Really? That's not our job, YouTube. That's yours. But sometimes you take a channel down for nothing, but now you get proof and you won't do it at all. As a strategy, we so that you collect the comments by taking screenshots before they are deleted by our system when they remove them so that we have concrete evidence of their cyberbullying and harassment. Yeah. Anyway. Like, I already did that. They're telling me stuff to do that I already did. Anyway. So here I answered Zeke. Answer Zeke now. As a matter of fact, not all is well. I am so disheartened that I'm able to provide specific examples on how this troll has used multiple accounts to impersonate and harass me and to harass other content creators, and you and your team continue to allow these accounts to remain on your platform. The recommendations you provided to me have already been followed. I know and already have blocked these accounts because they have harassed me, but I cannot do that throughout the entirety of YouTube. This troll continues to go to other content creators at random, mostly ones I've never heard of, to spam and harass them.
Welcome.
Yeah, I've got that blocked, thank God. I also have already reported all those channels as well as many other in my community, and those channels still remain. I would maybe have even given you the benefit of the doubt if just typical unusual usernames were used to spam others. However, these atrocities, community guidelines, violations are within the usernames themselves. In case, what usernames that continue to impersonate and harass myself and other content creators that your team is allowing to stay on your YouTube platform is unknown to you, let me spell them out here in this email with their corresponding URL. Anybody that I haven't said hi to yet, I will in a minute. I'm sorry. All right, so this one is a really bad one. So I'm going to pull it up, though. So this is the name of the channel. Pudge069, My Holes Baby. So the community guideline offense, impersonation and harassment and cyberbullying. So I'm going to show y'all this in just a second. The profile picture and the banner of the channel is an actual picture of me. The troll also uses very grotesque language in the description stating, I am a homosexual veteran, and I am proud of hardcore, this is a quote, I am proud of hardcore anal sex with my drinking buddies, while fantasizing about dipping Solid Snake smegma like dipping tobacco. I want pulsating video game cock in my eye sockets and nostrils. Shit on me, Randy. That is what's on there. Let's pull that up now. Look at this. And look at the about section. That's what that said. Friend, July 2nd. They still have that on there. But apparently that doesn't violate anything, YouTube, according to you. According to you, that's not a violation. There's a lot of other ones. Anyway, we've talked about all that stuff. We all see how they're breaking the community guidelines. But anyway. So anyway. With everything completely revealed on this email, how this troll is violating YouTube's community guidelines continuously via their usernames, are you still saying you and your team still stand by with the resolution that was given that no community guideline violations occurred? If so, that means you are allowing these toxic, disgusting, and atrocious channels to remain on your platform that continuously break YouTube's community guidelines and make the YouTube community more toxic and less safe. You stated in your previous email, we suggest that you and your fellow creators who are impacted by these channels work together to bring these channels down for good. However, how are we to do this when many of us have reported these accounts over and over and you allow them to exist on your platform? At this point, we have done everything in our power and done what was asked of us to report these community guideline strikes. The least your team can do is at least reach out to each and every one of these troll channels to at least get them to change their usernames to something that does not break your guidelines. We are unable to try and do this because this troll does not provide any way of contacting them. Because of the nature of this troll, though, I do not believe they will respond to your request. This is because this troll only seeks to harass and cause division, disruption, and toxicity within the YouTube community. If they do not change and don't respond, then these channels listed above should be removed due to constantly breaking YouTube's community guidelines. I'm ready to start feeling that YouTube support is actually here to support its actual content creators, partners, instead of feeling like YouTube support is swatting us away like flies due to being a nuisance that has to be dealt with. For your convenience, I attach the examples of the spamming the troll has done in various channels. I eagerly await your response to this query. Anyway. And then they sent, I hope all is well. Thanks for all those links and screenshots. I'll provide them to our internal team so we can investigate further. We're providing you an update as soon as possible. Thanks for your patience and understanding. Then I said, Zeke, giving you more information because the trolls struck again when I was streaming last night. They continued to harass me and other viewers while they were watching my stream. They would do this by spam while also impersonating me and other viewers. I'm going to attach some screenshots from the chat and discuss. And I just flat out with each screenshot, I told them what was going on in case they didn't know. I'm going to attach some screenshots from the chat and discuss what was going on with each screenshot. And then I said, yes, all the channels were blocked and hidden from my channel and reported, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, so here's one of them. So Joyful Death, a lovely person. They're impersonating Joyful Death. Damn. Truth Hip Hop, thanks for the $5 donation. It says, I'm chasing blacks off my lawn. That's something she would never do. They impersonated her, and she's over on Twitch all the time anyway. So that's them doing that. So then again, this is in my channel. Pudge007 is live now. Come watch in my channel. I bought it the stream, but they're talking about the stream poll, member votes, because remember they somehow did the member or whatever. I don't know. Anyway, again, Pudge007 is live now. Come watch doing that in my channel. So you can tell, here's my bot, the actual bot. It's as you can tell, it's has a the moderator badge on it. There's also a Pudge007 bot that doesn't. So they're mimicking my bot. And they're saying, hey, to Nathan Myberg, you've been permanently banned from the chat room, which makes no sense. But there they are impersonating my bot. And there's that throbbing, veining dicks one again. The wrench, yeah. And then, say, here's me specifically. So how can you say this is not impersonating me? My profile picture, my username. Hey y'all, hope you're enjoying the stream. My mother currently has a 20% summer discount on her OnlyFans content. Check her out at Mama Pudge. But apparently that's not breaking community guidelines. Thank you, Baby Squash. I appreciate that. Yeah, whatever. Anyway. Yeah, I know. The D's Nuts one. Yeah. Anyway. Okay, so, and then again, they switch it off to someone else. Hi there, thanks for writing us back. My name is Irish, stepping in for my colleague Zeke. Damn Irish. Ugh. I'd like to let you know that I got your message regarding the troll in your channel. Please be assured that I was able to provide them to our internal team so that we can investigate further. We'll provide you with an update as soon as possible. Thanks for your patience and understanding. All right, so I said, Irish, sounds good. Just writing again because I've streamed twice since I last wrote back to you guys, and the troll was again around in the past two streams. Just giving you more screenshots with the explanation in this email with what was going on with each screenshot. Truth Hip Hop, I said thank you for the donation, man. You didn't hear me? I said Truth, thank you so much for the $5 donation. I did say hi. I said thank you.
What are you buying?
And Kevin. Kevin, thanks for the $2 holla, baby. Appreciate it, bud. All right, so here's some other ones. Scroll screenshots. So here's one where he's impersonating Papa Agron. His YouTube, his channel. Again, how do I know this isn't Papa Agron? He's a moderator in my channel. So his name would be Blue. And he would have a wrench by his name. He says, what's up, my dude? This stream thing is cut to watch my sleep lock instead. So, again, he's a good friend of mine. So I definitely know it wasn't him. Hey, Eric, what's up, buddy? Probably. And then here's one. Pudge's wife. So I'm thinking of divorcing. Okay. While she's like standing right next to me. Not right now, but when that happened. And then here they are doing the Pudge 007 bot again. Again, I'm giving evidence. Let's see. So here's one that they impersonated Pokemon Professor Tony. Here's the real one, and here's the fake one. So, as you can tell, they were banned, and here's the fake one. And here's the real one. So, here they go. They said, hi there, thanks for writing us back. I just received feedback from an internal team. I was told they are still investigating on your concern. I'd like to let you know that as well that I got your message regarding the troll on your channel. Heart boy, hey buddy. Hey everybody. Hi everybody that I haven't said hi to yet. I'm so sorry. Please be assured that I was able to provide them to our internal team so we can investigate further. We'll provide you with an update as soon as possible. I know, Tony. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Tony. And then here we go. Here we go. After all of that, here's what they said. Hi there. Thanks for patiently waiting for our update with regards to your concern. I'm sending you this email to let you know that I just received feedback from our internal team. Upon a careful review of your channel's report, unfortunately, why would they put that? Unfortunately, we were unable to identify community guidelines violation in the content you reported. Let me read that again. After all of that I just read, they said, upon a careful review of your channel's report, unfortunately, we were unable to identify community guidelines violation in the content you reported. I mean, how incompetent can you be? Many thanks, Irish. So here's what I said back. This is the last thing I said to him. Irish, it is obvious you and your team do not give two shits about your partners on this program. It was as I feared. We are only a nuisance that you shoo away after you act like you investigate the issue. If you even read what was being reported to you, you would understand this is not a content creator that is doing this, but a troll who creates many accounts that is trolling live streams, and I gave you numerous violations of your community guidelines this troll has done. From your response, what I'm able to determine from you and your team is that you are either too lazy to take care of this issue or just do not care. I'm very disappointed, and it appears I will have to resort to reporting your lack of willingness to help your content creators on social media and other outlets, with you stating multiple times the community guidelines were not violated, next to the blatant examples of them being obviously violated by the troll in question. I expected more from you and your team, but it just goes to show that YouTube really doesn't care about the people who provide the content on their platform. Anyway, that's what we've been dealing with. That's what we've been dealing with. So, again, that's been happening the last few days, and they've been doing it on a lot of other, again, they have been targeting a lot of other people that are either live streaming the same time as me or even when I'm not. Spam their channel, make it look like it's me, and then people from their channel will go to either my live stream if I'm live streaming or to my most previous video. And again, they're trying to stick up for their content creator that they like, which is, I get that. But at the same time, you know, I've given multiple examples how it's definitely not me or anyone, my moderators or my community. So, if for some reason you're still watching this part, so again, I'm going to make this a video. And if you're coming to watch, you know, I mean, just kind of go through the ins and outs about what I've actually tried to do to contact YouTube to get this resolved and the brick wall that I hit. I just want you to know that I have gone way out of my way to try to resolve this issue. And YouTube has not done anything. So, I've done many things for me. I mean, I've done many things to try to show that for you guys. So, I hope that helps to at least clear some things for y'all that maybe are watching this video. So, I appreciate y'all watching this. I love y'all. Hope to see y'all soon. Anyway, all right.